¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás, Laz?
¿Cómo estás?
Muy bien, muy bien. Gracias. So, bienvenido a Entertainment Affair. We're very excited to have you here, to have a little bit of your time to ask you a few questions. Primero que nada, felicidades, un latino más triunfando en Hollywood.
Man, aquí estamos, batallando, echando para adelante la raza, ya tú sabes.
Gracias por poner el nombre de los latinos muy en alto. So let's talk a little bit about MM on the Boys. I want you to tell me a little bit of your personaje on the series for those that might not be familiar with the show or with the comic.
Okay, so Mother's Milk es parte del grupo The Boys. And el show básicamente se trata de dos grupos. You got the Supes, que son los superheroes, los superhéroes, y tienes The Boys, que viene siendo los anti-heroes, pero también somos héroes. Y la razón es por esta. No todo lo que brilla es oro, right? Mm-hmm. Los superheroes, they look perfect in front of us. You know, you got Homelander and Queen Maeve and A-Train, todos estos poderes, 100%, you know, powerful, almost gods, because people worship them. Mm-hmm. But when you pull the curtain aside, behind closed doors, ¿qué cosas son? Son vanidosos, son narcisistas, son mentirosos, son racistas, son usan drogas y todo tipo de cosas para tener poderes. Entonces, enseña que en la vida quizás las apariencias son una cosa, pero la realidad es otra. Y si tuvieras tú unos poderes que nadie en el mundo te puede parar, ¿qué tipo de persona fueras tú? You know, and so ahí es donde venimos nosotros. Nosotros estamos batallando contra ellos porque todos hemos tenido una pérdida por culpa de estos héroes que están supuestos de protegernos, pero abusan de su poder.
Yes.
Y we're not going to take it anymore.
I love that. I love that. Cuéntame, how has your experience been working with Eric Kripp, Seth Rogen, and for show's creators? Tell me a little bit more about that experience.
I love it because Eric Kripke in particular, who's the showrunner, he's the guy that actually is running the writer's room. He's a collaborator. You know, there's a few times where I might be reading a script and I think that Mother's Milk should do this or should say that, or, and he's very open to us pitching him ideas.
That's
you
great.
Know, he's not one of those guys that says, this is the Bible, that's it, my word is God, shh, don't bother me.
He's not
like that at all. Es mucha colaboración. Y mucho de lo que tú ves en los episodios son parte de lo que recibimos en el libreto, pero también otra parte de lo que nosotros agregamos al personaje cuando le damos vida al personaje y al momento. Hay un monologue en episodio 4 donde mi personaje empieza a revelar cosas de su pasado. Ese monologue lo escribí yo y Eric me permitió escribirlo para que tenga más, you know, más sentido como personaje, porque cuando uno vive esa vida de Mother's Milk, va a decir las cosas diferentes. Entonces, ese tipo de colaboración me parece que es tan especial en nuestra dinámica de cómo trabajamos, que siempre le da al show un poquito más de realidad.
And I love that you talked about that, de poder personalizar de cierta manera tu personaje. Hablando de eso, has there been any other experience from your past characters in other different movies or whatever that you've brought onto set for this one? Have you incorporated anything that you've learned along the way from other characters? Or how did you develop this character?
Yeah. No, definitely. You know, a lot of characters that are not based on someone, you have to make them up in your head. And I'll tell you what I love, the biggest compliment that I get from my fans is when they tell me, I didn't know that was you. Because that tells me that I successfully created a different human being from who I am. It wasn't Laz, it was something else.
Correcto.
And that to me is the best compliment that I can get. I've pulled from people from my past, from relatives, from drug dealers that I looked up to. You know, the guy Phoenix Calderon in Fast and Furious that I played was really this guy that I grew up idolizing in my neighborhood, who was a drug dealer named Louis King, a Dominican drug dealer that to this day, he had a profound impact on me never selling drugs and me never going the bad route, because he wouldn't tolerate it. He would show me why I should never do that.
Wow.
So there was a good side to him that a lot of people didn't know because they were afraid of him. But he embraced me and he took me under his wing and he showed me, he's like, this isn't for you. So there are people that I may play in different movies and shows that I actually directly pull from real life.
If you were to take Compound V, what would your superpower be and why?
Ooh, that's a good one. That's a real good one. Man. Okay, so if I could,
piénsalo bien.
If I could pick my own superpower, it would be to read people's minds.
Ah.
Because can you imagine if no one can lie to you because you know exactly what they're thinking?
And you're going to call them out on the spot.
You're going to call them out on it. Becky, you're not laughing right now. You hate my guts. No, I'm kidding.
Man, one last question really, really quick. Favorite Cuban dish?
Oh, man. Ropa vieja.
Love ropa vieja.
Vaca frita. I love vaca frita.
Bueno, muchas gracias, Laz. I appreciate your time. Thank you so much. And we can't wait to watch you once again in the second season. Gracias. Un beso.
All right. Igualmente.